So let's look at what lock synchronization looks like. So we said that a lock, or mutex, is just a location in memory. So let's say that we are using integers to represent the lock structure. So really, a lock is just a number. We initialize a lock variable, so you pass a lock variable to initialize to, let's say, a lock init function, and what it's going to do is set the lock to an unlocked value, which let's say that's 0. So pretty much lock initialization is just write 0 to that memory location that represents the lock. 0 means unlocked in this case. And now the lock function, the function that tries to acquire the lock and make sure that we're alone in doing that, will do something like this. It will spin as long as the lock var is 1, which is the locked value, and once it sees that lock var is 0, not 1, it's going to put 1 in that value to mark it as locked, and then we can enter the critical section because others will now see our 1 and spin there. And then to unlock, we will just set the lock variable back to being free. Once we do this, coherence ensures that whoever is waiting here now sees a 0 and acquires the lock themselves, so we let them go into the critical section. But this lock function doesn't really work. Suppose you have two threads, the purple and the green, that come to this point at the same time. The lock was initialized to 0, both of them read the lock var for the first time, see 0, both of them exit this loop because the lock var is not 1, so both of them come here, write 1 to the lock var, and then leave this lock function, and now both of them are in the critical section, which is what we were trying to prevent. What we really need to correctly implement the lock function is that the looking at lock var and seeing 0 and the writing to lock var of 1 needs to be atomic, which means we really need to do this in a critical section of its own to make sure that when we see a 0, we end up writing 1 before anybody else gets to see a 0. Or at least, when we see a 0, we try to write 1, but we know if we were the one to write 1 or if somebody did it before us. We should not write 1 if somebody succeeded in writing 1 before us. So we have some sort of a paradox here in that we need locks here in order to implement the lock function. So how do we ever support a lock function? Because in order to have a working lock function, we really need to have a lock and an unlock here.